fight back the tears? Does it take an eternity breaking all the fears? What will the passenger do when he hears that he's already paid for the crown on the southbound train going?
Thank you. crit, you creeps, you lousy, cummy, pink old rat. Hippie sense of... I'm gonna get down and do some of my heavy political material now. Yes, sir! Right off! Down! Yeah! Famine, war, despair, plague, Richard Nixon, doom! Gonna talk about it now. Get down. Are you ready now? Good, I'm really glad. Skidding out. Skidding in the turn. It's our usual slick actors.
No, we've already had it.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. It isn't. Don't tell them.
Shh. Fake it, Dave. Fake it.
I'm faking it, man. I'm faking it. Best I can. Here it comes. So I'm going to fake it at you now, folks.
Guinevere had gold round circle endlessly. I sing in silent harmony. Both shall be free. First rain of winter, first fall from grace. It's my first hollow echo in the halls of praise. How could Samson? I thought he was blind as a bat. Thank you.
Ah, without a net. Thank you.
Thanks, Mom.
There's some giant frogs out there, I see. Ah, heat.
They turn them back on. Heat. We have an agreement here.
As long as we're nice and don't sing anything anti-American, they keep the heaters on for us.
Hey, what are we doing, man?
Hey, man, what are we doing, man?
If you ever wondered who was driving, you know now.
Either someone's the War of the Roses.
Hey, that's it.
In England, the War of the Roses, the white rose and the red
rose. Which side are you going to be there?
Oh, I'm going to be whichever side blooms the most, longest. You know me. Find a thin line between what everybody wants. We are doing this.
Do I play on it?
No.
Thank God.
My entire future's in this man's hands, I...
But really, I don't think there's more than about 14 cells left in here that are holding hands, frankly. I don't know. It's his fast set of reflexes. I just watch his lips more. Griba snorting on the hornet?
Someone from Wisconsin, obviously.
From his neighborhood. Whatever it is, you can't land it here. Get your next one, John.
Where did that come from? You know what I mean?
It's a depression, man. Everybody needs a job. Come on.
I think we're out here. We're doing. Basically, we're out here because we have an enormous batch of new songs, and we've been going flat crazy to sing. You're in for it.
You may think you're gonna hear all that good old shit from the Summer of Love, but you're in for it. Ha! Do you know it's the sixth anniversary today of Woodstock? Here's an old song that we just felt like singing again.
To each other and get horny here for a minute.
I'm gonna do this with my friend Donna, who's sitting right here, whose birthday it is today. Holding you close and distant before a fire. The pressure in my chest when you breathe in my ear. We both knew this would happen when you first appeared. My lady of the island. The brownness of your body in the fire glow. Except the places where the sun refused to go. Our bodies were a perfect fit. In afterglow we lay. My lady of the island. Letting myself wander through the world inside your eyes. You know I'd like to stay here until every tear runs dry.
I thought it was cold.
Sunshine light the stage and the red lights on. I never want to finish what I have just begun with you. My lady of the island.
I'm going to do a new song of David's, which I added a couple of words to, and he keeps referring to it as a Crosby, Nash song, when in fact it's entirely his, and I just put the words in for a couple of places.
I'm singing this new Crosby, Nash song.
See?
First one. There's a second one already, but you don't get to hear it yet.
Crosby, Nash, finish.
It's so finished, you just don't get to hear it.
Hey, I've been singing for
That's not true. I'm not a lie. What a sense of responsibility.
You cannot take this man at face value. Would you smoke? Well, forget that.
It's California gun. Section. His name's Craig Doherty, and every time that I go to play or anything, or I guess for him too, just now everything that we go to record or anything, we ask this guy to come and play because he sort of plays right.
Right. Yeah.
And we were going to ask him to play a couple things with us tonight, and I would like you to welcome him. His name is Craig Doherty.
Nice.
He's a personal friend of Richard Nixon's, too.
Speaking of...
You dumb.
Isn't that a rotten thing to say about him? It's not true at all. He wouldn't even talk to him. Honest. Anyway.
We're gonna do this new country song that I just wrote that's on me and David's next album, whenever that comes out. And right after that, we're gonna take a short 10-minute break and we're gonna come back and sing lots more songs for you.
Yeah, we'll be right back.
Can I get some of that?
Where was that?
Hey, Moon!
I think the moon's better than the spotlights, but...
You're right.
What I was thinking, too, but...
Wouldn't that be
really
great if they turned out all the lights and we just played by moonlight?
It'd be very weird.
Do it! Do it! Do it!
But now how do we tell the black ones from the white ones?
A sign on the highway, I was driving along, way home on a hilltop, is where I belong. I took a look at the hole where my head used to be, and I'll sing you a song that descended on me, the way look up a friend, 'cause I heard that the house and the barn had a blend. I took a look at the hole where the bird used to be, 8 miles high. Sing you a song because he sang one for me. Was here tonight. This is a song about a lady I knew for a while who used to She didn't used to drink a lot. She used to drink strangely, like she used to like margaritas, but didn't like the salt, stuff like that. I was standing on stage at Carnegie Hall, and it was me and David's show, and he went off stage to do something and didn't come back. And I was standing outside there, just humming and hawing and looking and tapping my fingers, waiting for David to come back. So my natural state, I did this funny song, which later influenced David into writing on the piano. And it's a silly little song, but it's super important to me. Sit yourself down at the piano, just about in the middle. Put all your fingers on the black notes anywhere you want to. Sing a song, right along, but understand that you can play. Yeah, I don't know how I did it then either. Filled in the gap. About a year ago, I went to a party in LA, and there were knife throwers and jugglers and stuff, and sumo wrestlers and fortune tellers and fairies and witches and stuff like that. And then I traveled overnight from the party to Delano, which was the headquarters of the field workers' food store. And the food store had nothing in it, and so, well, we did this benefit and bullshit, but this this song came out of that experience. It's called Field Worker.
That piss us off. We got one winner.
Graham got it.
From a guy in they modernized all this crap. Ben doesn't anymore. We got this one letter from a guy who'd been busted for about 3 joints and he was doing 10 years. And yeah, I know. It's easy to say boo, it doesn't do shit.
That's true.
The guy was in there, you know, so don't just say boo, think about it. Anyway, it's changing now. It's cracked a lot of places, but when he got this letter, it didn't make a hell of a lot of sense to him, because it was already, you know, a $5 fine in Ann Arbor, and here was this kid in Texas, and he was facing 10. And that's serious biz. I don't know if any of you have been in jail. I've been in jail, and it's really the pits. It's really not happening. Anyway, it didn't seem to make a great deal of sense to him, so he wrote this song. It's another one of those ones that he wrote that I wish I had. I'm really proud of it. It's called Prison Song.
Kids in Texas smoking grass. 10-year sentence comes to pass. Misdemeanor in an arbor. Ask the judges why. Friend took me aside, said I had to leave you for buying something from a friend. They say I've done wrong for protecting the name of a man. They say I had to leave you, so now I'm bidding you farewell for much too long. And here's a song to sing for every man. It's an open door. There's not a rich man there who couldn't pay his way and buy the freedom that's a high price for the poor. Said to her kids, I'm gonna have to leave her. Buying something from a man and selling something I did wrong. And although I did the best I could, I'm gonna have to leave ya. So now I'm kissing you both farewell for much too long, much too long. And here's a song to sing for every man inside. If he can hear you sing, it's an open door. There's not a rich man there who can pay his way and buy the freedom that's a high price for the poor. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have to suffer too.
What are you gonna pull out of that?
It's Joel Bernstein, he's the brains of the outfit. It's the only one you know. Very well preserved for a 50-year-old man, don't you? Honestly.
Dave's waltz section. These are all...
I just realized. Kids seem to get it together.
I keep trying to figure out which songs to sing, and I put them together without really thinking about it. These are all Marvis and the Harvey. See, if you all yell at the same time, it just comes out glish. It's nothing, you know. Multiple cancer. Anyway, so I have a new song I'm gonna sing. See? But that guy that played if you yell too loud, we can't get out there. We don't have any knobs to turn up here.
Piano!
So we're gonna ask that guy that came out and played piano before Craig to come out and play the band with him. He plays this one song really incredibly. This is a song about something that happens in this town fairly often. It's one of the 1,001 ways for a musician to lose his mind and forget what he's doing. And I'm writing a book called that someday. Anyway, this one is called Getting to the Stage Where Winning is the Only Thing That's Important to You. And it's about a guy who's sitting in an empty football stadium going crazy about winning. It's called winning. And I think Craig kind of expresses the state of mind first and then we tell the stories. If you give us a moment.
Blowing past in the room.
still hear last Sunday's roar. Since then, pulls his coat tighter over his knees, and he listens to people.
Checked out was just a shuck, so you're on your own, you know.
Page 43 was always missing.
Yeah, really, every damn time. And here's a song that happened to me. Watching this play,
my mother. She was lying in white sheets there. She was waiting to die. She said, if you just reach underneath this bed and tie these weights, I could surely fly. She's still smiling, but she's tired. She'd like to hear that last bell ring. Oh, she's still, but she would stand up. One of the best things about it when you go sailing is if you get far enough away from land, you see whales. And we love them. They're just, they're graceful as hell, and they're really fine. They really do get you. They really make you feel good when you see them. They're beautiful. And there's this one other unfortunate fact about them, which is they're knocking them off faster than they can make them. And easy enough to say boo, but it's better to do something. Anyway, Nash wrote this song about whales. It's because we love them. It's another one of those ones I wish I wrote. It's called Wind on the Water.
Thank you.
Craig Durgee plays beautiful electric piano on that song.
People on the shoreline, land.
on my shoulder, I guess I'm going to set a course and go.
God bless you all. Good night. Great juggling.